table, what we refer to as table one. This table number two, I'll back up and you'll hopefully see the whole thing.
Yeah.
Panoramic view. For spreading the word. We're going live. Put my glasses on. I can see what you guys are doing. Alrighty. Thank you, Peggy. Okay, I'm going to walk around here. This is the back wall. Woo, let's go up, 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 up. One of our many bridges. This is all hand laser cut and designed by Roger. Here's a stream. You can see the different variations of the blue foam to the other kind of foam, and this foam has been mudded. We call this mudding. And Kathy is in the process of painting. I'll show you her magnificent paint job in the other room with the Rio, the Pecos River Gorge Mountain. It's incredible. But where Kathy is standing is where the museum visitors will be able to crawl underneath the table. And this is a whole pop-up area here where you can be surrounded by the trains in the actual display. This is, we refer to this as display one. Some of the designs that the Traingineers are working from. And you can see the intricate carving that goes on. Here's a really good example of that. So there's a lot that goes on any custom layout, from the design obviously to the excellent carpentry. The bases of these tables are really incredibly handcrafted. To the laying of the track, you really need engineering going on, wiring going on, and then you've got all the scenic elements that are applied to it, and the accessories, whether it be a bridge, a building, and in this particular display, you're going to have buildings going on. I believe this is the downtown Houston area. And again, here, let's go up close up to some carving going on here. So Peggy, can you hear me? I don't have to type this, right? You can hear me if I answer your question. These will go down in 3 53-foot trucks. This all comes apart. So once it's put together, it's actually dismantled, and it goes into 3 53-foot trucks, and it'll be headed down to Houston the end of the month. Up there, that is going to be where a mountain's carved. Let's go into the other room. Oh, this is going to be a really cool little cavern. Oh, yes, you can hear me. Yay! I don't talk too much. I'll have to talk a little bit more. Anyhow, so this is going to be a cavern. Underneath, I believe it's going to go somewhere in there. Yeah, right in there is where that tavern's gonna go, and so kids can walk in there and they'll actually see trains running in there. A little cavern, not a tavern. I think I said tavern. Cavern. But come on, let's go in here. And here is the backside of, here's the Enchanted Rock right here, and this is the mountain of the Pecos River Gorge. And Kathy has finished up painting here. You can see it looks like it's been standing here for years with some rain action, some snow action. Just really, she captured a wonderful, wonderful pictures and colors with the paint. And this is Enchanted Rock right here. And what they are doing now is, once it's painted, now they will landscape it. So we've got lots of trees and foliage and flowers and blue bonnets. You can see the tunnels there. Here, let's get close up here. And these trees, we don't make these trees, they are hand done. We did make some trees actually, but these ones we get out of, oh goodness, where's Bill? It's out of Tennessee, I believe. I'll have to double check on that. But these are all hand done. This bridge is all hand done. You can see some of the pieces here that will be going up. And here's some bushes that they're starting to place. And here you've got Ben. Hi, Ben. He's doing some ballast. Are you working on some ballast?
Bit of everything, actually. I'm doing ballast and scenic at the same time.
Very cool. Let's take a look at what he's doing a little bit closer up. Now, you're not going to leave these guys here, right?
That's a new train. It's a new train design.
Oh, wow. So you're putting some glue down?
Yeah, so what I'm doing is I'm actually doing a bit of ballast and scenic at the same time. Mostly to save some time and also so we get some cool blending going on. Right now I'm doing this riverbank area and just finishing up all along here.
It's really coming together. Good. Let's take a look over here. So this is what you just did this morning, Ben, or no?
Probably in the last 30, 40 minutes.
Right in here, huh? How cool is that? Wow. That's beautiful. What a difference it makes.
I know.
Really, I love these, the little guys you put in here.
Yeah, it's sort of that rock fall from the cliff face, and then you get some of the shrubbery.
So realistic. And this is all hand done as well, this Union Pacific, the bridge,
yeah,
correct?
Yeah, we painted that, added some rust effects, some weathering, added the wooden plate here, which I think came out real nice.
Very cool. Alrighty, you can really see what Ben is talking about here as far as the rock fall. So really, every detail will be thought on, every inch of this table. It's really magnificent to see it come to life once it's been painted. You think it's just really something else again, but then when the scenic application is put on, it just takes it to another entire level. This is fun watching Ben do this right now. See?
Boom!
Pop!
Have all my buckets of different scenic material laid out.
I'll take a picture of that.
Makes it a little bit easier for me to grab what I need.
Oh, that's great. Big buckets.
Everything's bigger in Texas.
Thanks, Roger. Roger Pete just says, over the top, fantastic artwork. We are going live. I don't know if I told
you that
then.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I didn't know that.
This is live on Facebook. And we've got some viewers.
Cool.
This is neat. Okay, let's walk over here. We'll come back and see what Ben's doing. But let's get up close and personal with the Pecos River Gorge Mountain. It will be going up here.
Yeah, it goes right in the middle there.
Let's check it out.
So I'm just using the static grass applicator to get kind of a glass effect going.
I agree, Roger. We have quite the talented artisan contributors. Absolutely. Let's get close up. See how fun?
It'll look a lot better once the glue is dry.
This is great. That's really, really something. Did you know if the bridge is back there?
It is.
It
yeah,
is? I'm gonna try and walk back here. I may lose the connection, guys. If I do, I'll say goodbye early on. I'm gonna take you back to the very back of the studio here, and I may lose internet connection. Because we've got a bridge they're working on. Let's go see. If I lose you, it's been fun. Let's see if it's here. Yep. Up there is a 17-foot bridge. This is the 17-foot Pecos River Gorge Bridge. Trains will be running over it, through it, on it. And the visitors will be walking underneath it. All of this is hand done, hand painted, and Roger designed all of this. You can see them working on the finishing elements, the cross pieces right there to the bridge, and Ben actually will be cutting them. Roger finished the design on this, and it's so it's just a matter of getting it all cut, glued, put together, painted. Thank you, Peggy. Hey, we're still connected. This is great. And you can see they've primed half of it and not the other half. Okay, I better sign off. I'm about to lose connection. Thanks for joining. Thanks for all the wonderful hearts and likes and comments. I so appreciate it. How much does that bridge weigh? Let's see, I've got... it's not like it's steel or something. I don't know, Roger. I'll have to find out how much it weighs. I don't know. But I'll show you where it's going to go. This bridge, let's come over here. The 17-foot bridge is going to go on the left side of the Pecos River Gorge Mountain right there. So that bridge that you just saw, imagine this, will be placed on the left-hand top corner. It's going to go there. And the very first display that I showed you when I started this live video will be over there. You know, pictured in the museum. And from that top of the gorge to the other that follows up above, you hadn't started carving, will be the 17-foot bridge. So I'll be walking, 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 and this will be underneath the bridge. Of course not now. Here, let's take a look. Here we have, this should make a little bit of sense. What I just described was, this is what the mountain that's built now, this is the one we're working on. The bridge will go from this point to that point, 17 feet. And that is the design of the entire Houston Museum of Natural Science Trains Over Texas layout. You're welcome, Jonas. This is great fun. You guys are watching this. This is great. And I know I'm kind of silent pictures here. I don't talk too much. I plan to get on better. This is maybe my, fourth maybe live video. Here, let's take one more look at this and then I'll sign off. Thank you all for watching live. And I will be doing more and I will give you the 5-minute warnings when I do. Here, let's take a pull up. Signing off. Thank you.